Hey guys, Duchess Brace here, and welcome back to my channel. Today we have the lovely Jayla Majette in my chair. If you guys don't already subscribe to her, she is a YouTuber as well, and she does some great lifestyle content and a lot of hair content as well for natural hair. So go ahead and subscribe to her channel. I'll go ahead and link it or put it in the video. So today we are doing a style. Jayla hit me up super duper last minute, and I just so happened to be in the salon clearing it out because today is my last and final day, but that is a story for later on in the video. All right, so Jayla hit me up last minute. I said, I'm here, I can do it. Initially, we started off trying to do at least two braids, but then two braids quickly turned to four braids, and now four braids turned to a whole full-on 5-hour style, guys. So stay tuned for this style. There's not much teaching I can do, honestly, on this style. If you guys follow all my videos, of course I'm braiding and stuff, but it's a new trending style for the summer, and we just decided to do it. She's been wanting it done, and so we're getting to it. First, Jayla has a whole bunch of hair, so the first thing I have to do is make sure that it is blow dried out properly and fully stretched so that once I start braiding, I don't want the braids to be super duper thick. So I want her hair to be as straight as possible without flat ironing it. So that's what I did. I went ahead and did a really good blowout on it so that once I get started on braiding, I really don't even have to add much hair to this. I practically just added hair to the end of her head, really. Some of them I added hair at the beginning, but for the most part, like, I started adding hair, most of the hair at the end, so to give her the length and stuff that she needed. Now, how did Jayla and I connect? So we both live in the 757 area. I had a client that is actually her sister-in-law, and so I believe that's how the initial connection was made for her to come to me. But she came to me, I think 2018, 2019, I did her hair, and since then we just followed each other on social media and stuff like that. And I've always kept up with her lifestyle content because I really love it. She does a really great job of showcasing her lifestyle stuff, and she's been doing it for a while. And so we connected back then, and ever since then she's hit me up a few times about styling her hair, but it just never worked out that way. And I recently hit her up because I was at a state where I needed some help. Like, being a content creator, sometimes you're on a lonely journey, and if you don't make friends in the industry, you really have no one to like guide you or help you. Like, you're on your own. You just got to figure it out on your own. And so many people gatekeep information. It's just absolutely ridiculous. So Jayla is one of those people that do not gatekeep, and I ended up reaching out to her and asking her some questions that were very personal, and she just was giving it to me like it was nothing. Like, here you go, and ever since then I just always felt like I owed her, and I've reached out to her even more recently and still ask her stuff. And while she's sitting in my chair now, she's giving me so much information on things that could definitely help you. Like I said, it's very lonely being a content creator. Yes, it's a great job to have, and yes, it's awesome financially, but at the same time, like, it's not that easy when you don't know your worth, when you don't have a team behind you, when you don't have an agent, when you don't have a management company, and you kind of have to figure out, are these people getting over on me? And what are the ethics for running this business? I've been doing it for a while, but I don't honestly feel like I know everything. So I just felt like, damn, I need somebody that's gonna like that might know more than me to reach out to. And she was just awesome. So I always felt like I owed her in some way, even though I'm sure she's not holding it over my head or whatever. So when she reached out to me, I absolutely was like, yeah, I got you, girl. Like, just come through. I was clearing out the salon, like I said, because this is my last and final day in the shop. That's a whole story. I got in this salon. I opened it in 2017. I was a kitchen beautician for a year or two. And then I decided to open up this luxury braiding salon, and I absolutely loved it. It was gorgeous in there. And over time, like, I just started aspiring for different things. I wanted to add this, add that. And then my YouTube took off, and there were so many things, so many businesses that I was running. I was running a course, I was running my products, I was doing so much. And the day-to-day of being in the salon and stuff, I felt like wasn't worth all the businesses that I was trying to grow. and the social media thing of trying to grow that. Of course, it worked great for my social media because I always had videos to showcase. I had way more videos that I was getting up on my channel daily because I was in the shop. So I had the time to like film styles and get you guys way more styles. But at the end of the day, like it just became like I was doing too much. And then I just so happened to get pregnant. And by the end of my pregnancy, I think around like November, December is when I fully slowed down from the salon of 2019. And then 2020 came, COVID hit. And yeah, after that, like I tried to go back in a little bit after like we were released to go back in, but it was just not working. So I kind of stayed out and I had the girls run it. And I believe the last thing you guys ever heard me say about the salon was that I was selling it to the girls that were in the shop. They had a great run for a year, but their partnership didn't work out. And so at the time when they were going through what they were going through, I felt like I wanted a salon again. I was working in my house. I was just super confused. And I felt like, I think I want a salon again. So at the time I was actually actively looking to open something else and open a suite or something. So when that happened, it just kind of fell in my lap. So we ended up transferring, the lease back over to me, and I had all these aspirations. I went ahead and I painted the walls pink. I resurfaced it and I had all these great ideas, but something just wasn't hitting for me in there. Like it really just wasn't clicking. I don't know what it was, but for some reason, I just don't have the best energy connection to the salon like I did way in the beginning. And I know this sounds crazy and lunatic to some people, but like I am big on energy. And if I'm not feeling it, or if every time I pull up somewhere and it just doesn't feel like 100%, I just felt like my heart wasn't in it. And so it literally sat for an entire year while I was under lease. The lease was luckily only a year because thank God I didn't have to break it or anything. So I did let it sit for a year. I could have done so many things in there while it was sitting, but I just let it sit because I really just didn't know what I was gonna do with it. And so I ended up closing it. Finally, I reached out to the company and was like, yeah, I'm done. Like they're, you know, wondering what I'm gonna do next or what I'm doing. I'm just like, I'm already established in other areas. I know you guys get a little bit confused sometimes about when I'm styling in my house, but the only people I style in my house are really just friends and family. And so sometimes people reach out to me and they're like, can you style my hair? You know, that's just not an option because I really only allow friends and family in the house and I only style them. So sometimes it might come off like, you know, why are you showing this? Why don't you take clients and stuff like that? And the reason is because I'm in my house. So if I was in a shop and if I was still in the shop or in the salon, I would most definitely take on more people, do more creative work and stuff like that. But because I'm in my house, it's just limited for me to do that. And so everybody that you see that comes around is mostly close friends or family. And then a lot of you guys get confused about my charging and stuff. You might make comments saying that, how much they pay for that and stuff. I really don't really charge people like that, honestly. If anything, if they really want to pay me something, I just be like, tip me what you want. But because I'm doing a video on them, like I only do the hair if I'm going to be able to do a video. So I'm kind of strict with it. So I do favors, but for the most part, if I'm going to do your hair, if a friend reaches out to me and they want me to do their hair, they already know that filming is going to be a part of it because I'm just not a full-on stylist anymore. I'm a YouTuber. So that is my job, is to basically film for you guys and put videos up for you guys. So there's really no favors being done as far as can you just come style my hair and we not like film it. Like that's not really happening because at the end of the day, I'm not a stylist anymore. I'm a YouTuber. So that's where, you know, you have to draw the line in certain things. And I don't know why I'm rambling and saying all this, y'all, but I just wanted to give you guys the background about what's going on. The hairstylist turned out fabulous. I don't know if y'all turned me on mute or not, so you could just watch the hairstyle, but look how good it looks. And she absolutely loved it, y'all. Her baby hair, she loved her baby hair to look like Lori Harvey baby hair, which I love too. Like I love how Lori Harvey do her baby hair. So I'm gonna leave that up to her. But yeah, the style is his style is coming out so great. But anyways, yeah, that's why you see all that stuff in the background. That's why you see boxes. That's why you see a ladder and all that. I'm just clearing everything out. And this is a very sad moment for me because, you know, when you accomplish something that you thought was so great or that was so amazing to you at a certain time in your life, like sometimes it's a little bit harder to close the door. But because I felt like I closed the door before on it, it's not hitting me as hard as it did the first time. But it's definitely done and over with. Like, I'm never, unless somebody opens up a business there that I need to step my foot in, like, I don't feel like I'll ever step my foot back in that salon. It's on the other side of town, and I just feel like I probably won't, you know, ever step my foot back in there. But she's doing her baby hair, and look how cute that looks. This looks so fire. I love how this style turned out. It was so worth doing this style, and of course she loved it. But if you guys like this style, go ahead and comment down below what you think. Go ahead and follow Jayla Majette or subscribe to her channel as well. Like the video if you like what I mentioned. If you want to hear more, go ahead and like the video. Let me know what you think and give me some word of advice if you can. And thank you guys so much for watching. I appreciate all the love. I appreciate all the comments. I appreciate all the like. If it wasn't for those things and you guys, I wouldn't be doing this. And so I just want you guys to know like how much I appreciate y'all for standing 10 toes down. And for all the new people, welcome.